It's a scientific fact that 97% of all humans feel utterly trapped and paralyzed by their lives. Sam Pulford was one of these men. But one day he decided to put an end to it. He told his wife,
"Honey, I'm going swimming!"
Sam placed his shoes on the beach and left the country. When they found his shoes, they assumed he was dead, swallowed by the sea. He had made a clean break from his life. Sam changed his name to Claude Dumont and became a choir director at a Unitarian Universalist church. At first, Sam thought he had found his place in the universe, his life finally had meaning. But soon he felt the walls closing in, and once again had to fake his death. He changed his name to Robert Bates and joined the army. He fought in World War III, where he served with bravery and honor. He experienced the ravages of war firsthand, and lost his closest friends in battle. When he returned home, he was greeted as a hero, but Sam was dead on the inside.
What are you gonna do now?
I'm going swimming. He then moved to Paris and became an investigative journalist. He sought out corruption and exposed it to the world. He married Cecile and had three beautiful French children. But he was still unsatisfied and once again faked his death. In fact, over the course of 27 years, Sam faked his death an amazing 35 times and left behind 18 children in different countries, but none of them was quite like Paul.
I'm from the future.
Paul was a mediocre boxer with a borderline psychotic disorder. Young Paul believed he was a sentient being from the future. This psychosis was a result of the fact that when the boy was growing up, Sam would crawl in through his window late at night and talk to him for hours in a belligerent and drunken state. This constant exposure to what Paul thought was his dead father left the boy unhinged and delusional.
Well, actually, I find talking boxing trite. Where I'm from, the future. Man's favorite sport is perpetual motion, but thank you for bringing that up. Next question.
Paul was reviled and mocked by the world. His one true companion was his fiancée, Elizabeth, who didn't care if he was from the future or not. Elizabeth was the world's greatest sword fighter and champion viola player. What neither of them knew was that Elizabeth's father, who had died before her birth, was none other than Sam. So the brother and sister lived together in sin, their very love an affront to God and a crime against all that nature holds sacred. Meanwhile, Sam moved to Berlin, where he became a leading avant-garde dancer. Paul's claims of being from the future soon gained credibility when he unveiled his designs for a perpetual motion machine that not only worked perfectly, but transformed the very basic structure of human society. Now having the capital to provide for his sweetheart, Paul and Elizabeth married. Unfortunately, the world was not able to handle the enormous responsibility that came with Paul's invention. His perpetual motion technology caused a chain reaction, which destroyed nearly 85% of the human race. Out of the wreckage, a totalitarian dictatorship rose to power. They singled out Paul as their scapegoat, and they claimed he was the root of all human suffering. They said terrible things about him. They said that he was the worst man who ever lived.
Maybe I am the worst man who ever lived.
Maybe you are.
I've done a lot of bad things. What do you think I should do?
Let's go overthrow the government.
Sam came forward and offered to kill his son.
How do you know you can kill him?
Because he sprung from my loins. Paul and Elizabeth crept into the dictator's inner sanctum and took the guards by surprise. Sam steeled his reserve and lunged forward to kill his son. Always the opportunist, Sam played along as if his had been a heroic sacrifice. As he died in his children's arms, he made one request: that they mix his ashes with gunpowder and transform his bodily remains into fireworks.